Good morning, students. Today in this session, I want to explain about Schrodinger wave equation in this unit. Now see that Schrodinger wave equation is related to quantum mechanics. The quantum mechanics deals with the study of the motion of the microscopic particle like electron that have both particle and wave like properties. Heisenberg has proposed that the position of electron cannot be determined accurately. Hence, we can predict the probability of finding electron in three-dimensional space around the nucleus. Based on idea of de Broglie dual nature of matter, Erwin Schrodinger in 1926 derived wave equation for a moving particle. It is called Schrodinger wave equation. That equation is dou square psi by dou s square plus dou square psi by dou y square plus dou square psi by dou z square plus 8 pi square m by h square into e minus v into psi equal to 0, where m equal to mass of the electron, e equal to total energy of the electron, v equal to potential energy of the electron, h equal to Planck's constant. That constant is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 erg into second, or 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joules in second. X, Y, Z are Cartesian coordinates, psi equal to wave function. Derivation. That is how to derive Schrodinger wave equation. Electron does not move around the nucleus in a fixed orbit. In so that, according to classical wave equation, with respect to stationary associated with a particle in coordinate system is psi equal to a sin 2 pi x by lambda. This is equation 1, where psi equal to wave function, a equal to amplitude or maximum value of psi, lambda equal to wavelength of standing wave, x equal to distance of the particle from the nucleus, partial differentiating psi with respect to x, we get dou psi by dou x equal to a cos 2 pi x by lambda into 2 pi by lambda. That is equal to 2 pi into a by lambda into cos 2 pi x by lambda. Again, differentiating, we get dou square psi by dou x square is equal to 2 pi a by lambda into minus sin 2 pi x by lambda into 2 pi by lambda. That is equal to minus 4 pi square a by lambda square into sin 2 pi x by lambda. That is equal to minus 4 pi square by lambda square into a sin 2 pi x by lambda. Here, a sin 2 pi x by lambda equal to psi. Already we know that psi equal to a sin 2 pi x by lambda. So, this equation can be written as dou square psi by dou x square is equal to minus 4 pi square by lambda square into psi. This is equation number 2. Therefore, dou square psi by dou x square plus 4 pi square by lambda square into psi equal to 0. This is equation number 3. The above equation represent wave motion of particle along x-axis. Since electron has a wave as well as particle character, if the electron is considered to move along x, y and z axis, then that equation can be written as dou square psi by dou x square plus dou square psi by dou y square plus dou square psi by dou z square plus 4 pi square by lambda square into psi equal to 0. Or del square psi is equal to 4 pi square psi by lambda square. This is equation number 4, where dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square is equal to del square. This is a Laplacian operation. Then 4 pi square psi by lambda square is equal to minus del square psi. That implies 1 by del square, 1 by lambda square is equal to minus del square psi into 1 by 4 pi square psi. This is equation number 5. But according to De Broglie's equation, we know that lambda equal to h by mv. Squaring on both sides, we get lambda square is equal to h square by m square v square. 1 by lambda square equal to m square v square by h square. This is equation number 6. From equation 5 and 6, we get m square v square by h square is equal to minus del square psi into 1 by 4 pi square psi. That implies m square v square is equal to minus del square psi into h square by 4 pi square psi. That implies m v square is equal to minus del square psi into h square by 4 pi square m psi. That implies half m v square is equal to minus del square psi into h square by 4 pi square m psi. That implies ke equal to minus del square psi into h square by 8 pi square psi m. Therefore, del square psi is equal to 8 pi square psi m by h square into ke. Thus, del square psi plus 8 pi square m by h square into ke into psi equal to 0. This is equation number 7. But we know that the total energy of the system is equal to the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. So that E is equal to total energy E equal to ke plus pe. That implies ke equal to E minus pe. Substitute the value of kinetic energy in equation 7, we get del square psi plus 8 pi square m by h square into E minus pe into psi equal to 0. Therefore, del square psi plus 8 pi square m by h square into E minus v into psi equal to 0. The above equation is known as Schrodinger wave equation. Next, significance of psi and psi square. First of all, what are the significance of psi? There are 6 significance are available. That is, first one, it is a wave function which is a solution of the Schrodinger equation. Second one, it represents the amplitude of a wave and describes how this amplitude varies with the distance and direction. Third one, it takes a positive value above the axis and negative value below the axis and become zero while crossing or intercepting the axis. So ensure that intensity taken on y-axis, wave function taken on x-axis, we get this graph. From this graph, it has no physical significance. The Schrodinger wave equation may have different values of psi. The significant values of wave function psi are known as eigenfunctions. These functions give significant values of the total energy of the electron. These values are called eigenvalues. Sixth one, each eigenfunction corresponds to an atomic and molecular orbital of an atom and a molecule respectively. This is the significance of psi. Next, what are the significance of psi square value? That is, first one, for light wave, it represents intensity of light. Second one, for electron waves, it represents intensity of electrons at any point. That is, it represents the probability of finding electron at different regions in space. Third one, it leads to the idea of orbital. Fourth one, if psi square value is 0, it is called nodal plane. These are the significance of psi square. Dear student, easy to try to understand after number of times practice of the derivation, easy to write the derivation of the Schrodinger wave equation. Thank you.